So I welcome you all for my seventh live in my page, Hastashri Arts and Crafts. Now in today's session, we will be dealing with the jute. We are going to explore with jute. Four items I will be sharing the procedure, and all easier, quicker and simpler techniques. Those who have got the materials, you can take it out. Others, please take out an A4 size paper or A3 size paper or even a portion of the newspaper also, because certain things are like origami style of folding. So you can get the folding, you can learn the technique of the origami style along with me. Okay, so now we will start with a small kind of, it's a basket, jute basket, just by using the origami style of folding. So for that we need the jute, of course the color of your choice. You can choose the color, whatever materials you have, you can take it. This is a small sized jute box to be kept on the table to store certain of your things, like when you remove your bangles or rings or earrings, chains, all those things you can just put into that and then you can have it safe. Okay, so for that size we need an A3, the size will be of A3 size paper. Okay, so I will be teaching you the folding in this and then I'll show you how it is done with the jute, because it takes more time when we do with the jute, pressing it and then waiting it for it to set. So now this is a jute, of course it is available in the market. Somebody had asked what is jute fabric. This is a sheet, jute sheet they have asked. This comes in a sheet form like this. At the back you have the rexin coated. In the front you have the jute. Apart from this you have the plain jute also without the rexin coating at the back. There are many colors available in the market, and then you need a fabric glue. Otherwise for jute you can use leather gum, which is available once again in the market, where you get the jute, or in other fancy stores also where you get the normal craft items, craft stores. And then of course the scissors. Now let us begin with the paper. Just take out an A3 paper. This folding is most important. You have to follow the same thing with the jute. Okay, take an A3 size paper. Now this is the length. Okay, for the A3, and this is the breadth. Now we have to fold it into half from the breadth, that is top to bottom, not lengthwise, just the other side. Fold it exactly into half, press nicely. See, for scoring, this is called scoring when you fold any fabric, or for that matter jute or on the paper. So what we should do is, scoring is a must here with the paper. On the paper you can just do it with the finger, but on the other hand when you do it on the jute, you need to fold it like this and then using the back side of the scissors you have to press nicely to get the impression. Okay, so that the next fold will be perfect. Now you need to fold it into half like this. Then mark the center over here. Fold it again this side and mark the center. Just mark the center. Now what you do is, when you do it with the paper or with the jute also, there is no need for you to apply the glue. But on the other hand, since jute is a little thicker stuff, we may have to apply glue here and there. Okay, now what you do is fold this and bring this end to the center. Hope you're all doing it along with me on a paper. So this should be like two, exactly folded into half. Now again into half. Then bring the one end of the paper to the center where I have marked. Then press it nicely. Of course, for the paper, a finger is more than enough. But on the other hand, with the jute, you need to press it either with a metal scale or with the backside of the scissors. Now, similarly, bring this end also to the center. Both the things exactly to the center like this. Okay, now we have made this shape. Now what you do is, here you have the two folds like this. We have already folded the paper. So the first fold, fold it like this into half, bringing it to this point. Press nicely, then again fold it on top. So give double fold. See, take only the first sheet of this folding, make an half a fold, then again to the top like this. Have you done like up till here? Okay, fine. Now you just turn it this side. So first fold is done on one side. Now on the back side, you have similarly the other flap also. Now what you do is, you bring this end to the center. Bring this end to the center like this. Press nicely. See, with the paper itself, you need to use a scissors. But with the jute, just imagine you need more time to press it, get the fine pressing on it. Okay. Similarly, the left side to the center, exactly to the center. This is a lovely small sized basket or a holder, you can call it. So now we are with this. Front side it's like this. At the back it is like this. Now you have the extension over here, that you fold it into half once again, and then again to the top, like how we did the first side, the front side. Okay, give a nice press. So it will be like this, like a chef hood. It will be like this. Okay, now what you do is, bring this point, that is, make a fold over here, bring it over here, nicely you press it off. You can do with a quality paper also, handmade paper also. An ideal gift for any occasion. You can just stuff it with some sweets and other chocolates, and then even for any other, for holding purposes, you can just place some artificial plant inside and can convert it into a pot holder also. Now you open this. This is only for marking. I'm just pouring it over here. Okay, just open it. Now it's like this. Now the final step, where we are going to finish the box, is you have to bring this tip, okay, to any one of the side, either to this side or to this side. Just hold it like this, give a press in the center, one side only, a press, and bring this tip over here, and then slowly you adjust everything, then the box is formed, a holder or a table. See, you get a square shaped box. Now you can just press inside and then get all the points perfect, the four corners. Then you can give a nice press on all the four sides, folding the bottom, all the four sides. Now the box is ready. Of course, this is without the lid, just a storage box. Okay, same way, using the jute, I have done it here with the same color what I've shared with you. See this. But here what happens is, this is a paper, but here the inner portion is seen here on all the four sides, so this should be covered. For that, I would go in for some decorative cotton lace, because this is eco-friendly style, so I would prefer to use cotton lace here. you apply glue, have some jump clips like this, because it takes time to dry also to get fixed. Otherwise you can just score it, you can just make some impressions like this with the scissors or with the needle, so that it will stick faster. Normally we do on jute, for sticking we do like this only. We just make lines with a sharp instrument so that the surface becomes rough. Otherwise it is very soft and smooth, but now here it is rough. Then apply glue on top. Take the cotton lace here I am using. This kind of decoration is left to one's own creativity. Now here you can put the jump clip or even the wooden clip also, just for the time being. Later on you can remove it. Then continue the pasting. Then we will do the third side also. You can even use a glue gun also. Hot glue you can use. If you want to make it, market it in a larger scale, then you can go in for hot glue. A quicker way of getting it fixed. But fabric glue is equally good, 100% it works out. Then the fourth side. Any doubt with the folding? How many of you have tried? Take out a paper and try it along with me, so that later on when you get the jute fabrics, you can try with that. Now we have done with the decoration. The extra can be cut later. Now let me stick it over here. Okay, now this is done. The top decoration is done. Now here you have some plain area. So what, if at all you want, you can use some handmade flowers with a paper, handmade paper. You can make flowers like this and stick. I'm going in, because this is eco-friendly style, I'm going in with the cotton lace and with the handmade paper flowers, such kind of attachments. Any doubt? Thank you, Seema. You have tried with the paper. Good, that's good. Please try it with the this thing also. Jute, and later you can share it to me. See, now the decoration is over. Let it dry. Towards the end of the session, I will remove all these paper clips and show you how it looks. How it looks. Okay. So we are now finished with the first piece. Then we move on to the second one. Second one is the see, these jute fabrics is available in all the craft shows. It comes in A4 size forms, assorted pack, A3 size, and then in meter form also. You get it in roll also. You just message me, I'll share you the address where you can get it. I'm in Chennai. I don't know about the other cities or other places. But as far as Chennai is concerned, I can just share with you the address of where you get this jute fabrics. Okay, the second one is a door hanging. So for the door hanging, we need a piece of another fabric, jute fabric. Here I have taken a blue color. Okay, then we need some motifs, Ganesh motif I have taken, and some piece of cardboard, some sticker stones. These kinds of motifs also you can, if you want to make some keychains, this kind of work with the jute, you can use these kinds of motifs also. This is terracotta Ganesh. This is also terracotta painted one. This is plain, and here this is the this is what do you call that, some fiber. Okay, fiber mold. And then for further enhancing, you can use these kinds of tassels also, which is readily available in the market. I had one, so I thought I could share with this also. So now what you should do is take a small sized thicker board. The measurements can be say for this will be around 4 centimeters with 3 centimeters length and breadth. Take this on the back side of the jute. You draw the shape of the board. This is a door hanging. You can hang it on the door, or you can even fix a magnet at the back and take it to the fridge or a keychain like that. You can convert it, okay, or a decorative bag hanging also, handbag hanging also. Take this board, place it on the back side of the jute fabric, leaving about 1.5 inch all over. So you can mark over here, and then on all four sides you leave about 1.5 inch. Now let us cut it. The center portion we are clear with. Now approximately we can cut the sides. This gap is a must because we are going to do something different over here, different technique. So this is 4 centimeters by 3 centimeters, 4 by 3, or you can have 3.5 by 2.5 also. This, I told you, this is only hanging, so let it be a little smaller. Say about half of 3/4 of a visiting card. Now you take this. What you do is, from the front side, you just try to remove the thread, the jute yarn thread. Just remove it like this. Now at the back you have the rexing coating, okay, so that you should not, we don't want that. Before you, without removing the strings, the jute cord, you cannot remove the rexing at the back. So for that, to remove the rexing at the back, you need to remove the jute thread from the top. So you just remove it like this on all the four sides. This is, that is why I told you we need to leave about 1.5 inch on all the four sides. Then similarly this side also, just remove it. A cute little door hanging, ideal for gifting once again. So you earn while you learn also, a pastime to profit time for you all. Just make as many as possible and you can just rock. Like this you need to do. I'll just show you on a different piece. I have done over here. Now see, now you can remove the rexing sheet at the back. This comes off just like that. Now this is what we wanted, okay. Now I'll just show you once again, because that was a darker background. Just from the top, try to remove the jute thread. Peel it off, okay, one by one you should do. Don't pull it too hard, do it as gentle as possible, because when you pull it hard, what happens is the sheet becomes like this. So after that, we are now with this, okay. Now make it straight on all the four sides, make it straight. Now you need to stick this board at the back of the jute. So for that, take fabric glue once again, apply lot of glue, little will not do, so you need to apply more glue at the back side of this board, paste it on the jute, give a nice press, take it, okay. Now you need to trim the sides equally. So one side you start with trimming it, similarly the second side, it should be equal. Now we are doing the fourth side, okay. Let it be equal on all the four sides. Now what you do is this back side should be covered. This white, I don't want this white portion to be seen. So what I have done is I have taken a normally this is a rexin kind of black fabric you get for, this is called the lining for jute. So this lining cloth is exclusive for the jute work. So take a small, the size of this board, and you need to paste it over here. So what I do is let it dry. Then before that, we will fix this also so that we can cover it like this. After keeping it like this, we can cover the thread also. So let me do that first. Apply glue here in the center, exactly in the center of the board. Place this tassel over here. Okay. And then apply more of glue all over the board. You can stick this rexin leather lining cloth, little extra, let me cut. So I always say whenever you do any work, the finishing should be perfect to professionalistic. Now keep it on top, press all over, let it dry. Okay, now you have the hanging, the provision given for this door hanging also. Then now you stick the motif whichever you want to, say the terracotta or the fiber or the unpainted terracotta Ganesh. If the size is smaller, you can go in for the smaller ones. This is a little bigger, so let me use a bigger sized motif. Place it in the center, give a press like this. Now to the sides, you can add some extra items to enhance it also. Here this is the self-sticking pearls, so I'm just peeling it off from the sheet and pasting it over there. Just a simple decoration I'm doing, very very simple. You can use your creativity and make wonders. For the festive seasons, especially in the south for Navratri, along with the Tambulam, we normally with the Manjal Kumkum, this thing, we give some sort of gift articles also. So this will hold good for that. Some sort of decoration, whatever materials you are with. There is no hard and fast rule that you should go in for this kind of decorative items like that. So now we are ready with the second item, a door hanging. This is a door hanging. In case if you want to take it to the fridge, you fix a magnet at the back and place it on the fridge without this hanging. Instead, you can have a small sized hanging at the bottom. So how do you like this? You love this? Okay, now the interesting part, the third item, I'm sure all of you would love that to do. We will go with that. See, for the jute box, for the first item, the size of the fabric is A3 paper. You know what is A3 paper? Or normally when we take a Xerox, we have A4 and A3. No, this is the A3 size paper, and one full paper I have used to get a box like this, a small holder like this. Okay, then the next one is a table deco with a jute. So for that we need a lovely piece. For that you need a different colored, about 2-3 colors or a single color, it all depends upon your, once again, your creativity. Here I have taken the mustard, I mean the golden yellow color, and then I want one green color. Apart from that, you can go in for red or blue blue or any other colors. Okay, now what do we do is, first you need to draw, this is going to be a peacock table deco. One second, I'll just clear. Just take all this one. You need to draw a peacock. And you look me around. It's there. So for that, I told you this is going to be a table deco. So draw a straight line. I have the template, but I'll just show you how to go about the drawing. Okay. Then you draw, mark the center over here and a line to the top like this. There is no size for this. You can make from the smaller to the bigger where you are going to place the item. Okay, if it is going to be in the showcase, a little medium size. If you are going to gift it, let it be smaller. And if you are going to keep it on your table in your office room, the cubicle, then you go for the medium sized one. So now from here, you make from this straight line, you make a U shape like this. Okay, then it should be like this. Okay, now the next one here, you need to make two more inner designs also. For that, a big heart shaped over here from the center, you start from the center, move to the left, to the right, make an heart shaped. I will draw with the sketch pen later, just to then another heart shaped in the center. So we are now with one heart shape, the second one, and then the third one. So three designs we have. Now here what you should do is, from this point or from the top, you can just make small petals like this. Feathers or petals we call it. This is a peacock, so I am making it as a feather. Once again, heart shaped. Okay, touching the outer line. Like this. It should be like this. Okay. Now, after you do this, the final will be like this. I told you one straight line, then joining the two lines, a small curved line at the top. Then inner you need to make a heart shaped, and to that again another heart shaped. Then you mark the petal, the feathers at the sides like this. Now after drawing the design, you need to cut the three pieces, one with the base color for the entire picture, that is for this. So keeping this as the template, you cut a yellow fabric. Then keeping the other two as template, you need to cut two different colors, or you leave it as it is, one with the yellow, one with the green, or one with the blue, or one with the pink, like that. You decide the color. So we need three pieces like this. Now we have to decorate the work. Now for that, the piece is already cut. So this is only the outline I have drawn. Let me draw the inner details. And then for this you need the liners, some colors, then Velcro tape you need, sequences you need, then molded clay you need, the glitter liners, some accessories, then of course glue. Okay, these are some of the items we need. Okay, now let us do. Now here on this, what you should do is, you can either using a pencil or a sketch pen, you can draw the feathers on this. So we'll start from the center. This is the center point. Let me mark and show you. It will be prominent. This should fall in the center. Okay. Now in this, start from here. We already have the curves over here. Follow that curve. After each two curves, make a design like this. Exactly after two curves. Similarly, this side also. This can be drawn with a sketch pen because I'm going to use a glitter liner, either blue or green. So I'm doing it with the sketch pen. No problem if you use the sketch pen also. Okay. Now we are ready with the base sketch. The next one we will do with the liner, glitter liner. Here I'm going to go with green and gold. Okay, just draw the outline. It should be bold enough, very thick. Squeeze nicely, let the liner be bold enough. A beautiful table deco. Just follow the instructions, note down the points. Slowly they are unlocking in many places. So now that shops will be opened also, you can get all the materials and start working with that. Certain places it's not like that, but overall we are getting back to our normal life very slowly, but so like this you need to do. So I'll do on one side. Then what you do is take the golden color, just close it to the green. Once again, make it bold. These are glitters. The size of the peacock also, it all depends on how big we want. Like this is the standard size which I'm doing here is from the top to bottom it is 11 inches, and here this is from left to right it is 10 inches. 11 inches by 10 inches I have taken. In that I have drawn the peacock pattern. This is the right time for you all to learn certain new things and then create with that. Okay. Now both the green and the gold I have done on one side. It's like this. This is a base. This is the base. This is the tip of the peacock. And then we have created patterns at the sides. Just like the feathers drawn with the sketch pen. And then on top of that, I have done it with the glitter green first and then with the glitter gold. Now let us decorate it. For decoration, of course, once again, it is your choice. Whatever materials you are with, you can go ahead with that. Now let me use some stones here, contrast color. So let me apply glue in each and every feather. To the bottom, closer to the bottom, I'm applying the glue. Then take one by one, you place it over there. So normally what we know about jute is We go to the shops, we buy jute bags, lunch bags, water bottle holders, then pouches, then sling bags like that. But for on the other hand, to make it little creative and then to make it little what do you say, decorative purpose, we are creating some items here. Okay, now after that you take white color cone liner and draw some patterns over it. These are all extra things which if at all you want to, you can just carry out. Otherwise, what are another suggestion is, this can be done on the canvas board also, canvas sheet also. You can cut the canvas sheet according to the shape and then you can do the work. In you don't get any colored canvas sheet, right? So what you do is, you can color all these gaps with regular like peacock color, green and blue and red, all those color combinations. You can paint these feathers and then you can finally align the peacock. You can either do over here or on the canvas sheet itself you can paint it. So here, since I have taken jute as the base for all the items, I'm doing it on the, I mean the liner work and the feathers, everything on the jute itself. Okay, this is as far as the outermost portion is concerned. We are now done with this. I'll just show you. You can make it little more grand also. Okay, then we need to do the second one. For the second one, I have already done it. So just cut the green color heart shaped, then at the sides I have stuck the gold ball chain and then the floral stones closer to the inner heart shape. That heart shape also I have done like this, and here the running glitter stones, diamond stones, I have stuck. Okay, now what do we do is, this is the base. Now we need to paste this, the center green color, this thing, jute fabric, decorated one. If as far as this green color is concerned, don't do anything in the center because we are going to place another piece on top of it. Okay, so just the outer, the tip and a little bit of decoration is more than enough. Now you paste it onto the base jute, press it nicely, leave it to dry completely, and then take the smaller one, apply glue. Paste this also on top of this. Give a nice press. You need to give setting time for this. Okay. Now next step, let us take cerulean blue. We will do a little bit of painting over here. One second. Where's the brush? Yes. Take little bit of cerulean blue or ultramarine or prussian blue for that matter, preferably acrylic colors. Just paint the center of it alone, leaving the sides as it is. Little bit of yellow should be seen, so that is why I am asking you to paint the center, leaving the sides little bit to be seen. Once again, this also in the heart shape. Okay, so now this is over. Next step, we have to make the face of the peacock. For that we need a molded clay. Okay. So now let us open this. You all know this comes, it's an epoxy compound, comes in one, two packs. One is a resin, the other one is a hardener. So mix both in equal proportion. you get a white dough. With that, we create items. Such a lovely versatile product. Take 1/3 of the resin and the hardener from each package. Just 1/3 is enough. Mix them nicely by touching little powder. Make a white dough. Now here you need to make the face and the neck of the peacock. The body we have done now. Okay, now see, there shouldn't be any marbled effect in this. It should be a pure white dough. See to it, otherwise it will not dry. Only when these compounds are mixed properly, it works out. Now how to make the face? Just roll it like this. First a ball shaped, then slowly you do make a teardrop or the carrot shaped. See here, teardrop or the carrot shaped. This is the second step. First was the ball. Now this is the carrot shaped. This is the lower part of the neck, and here is the beak. How do you do that? Just hold it and then you put it on top of this index finger like this. Then touch little powder in your hand. Give a press from the sides first, then from the front, top to bottom, then the sides, then top to bottom. Just 2 or 3 times will hold good like this. You get the beak and the head and the neck and the lower part of the peacock. Okay, now using a pencil, mark the eyes over here, give an impression, and similarly this side also. Okay, now next one, just one second, yeah, it's here. Take a paper clip or a safety pin, make impressions here on the neck of the peacock. Make small impressions like this. Just press it before it dries completely. You get the impression done on the clay. Now this is the peacock. I'll just drop it down. Okay, now what do we do with this? Now give me that piece. Now this is the base we have done, right? It's not it. Now here you need to apply glue. Just apply glue here. Then you place it over there. Okay, just give a gentle press at the sides. Don't press much. Just superficially you press it. And then try to adjust the beak. Okay, and then before it dries, take a flower shaped kundan stone. Here I have taken a white color. This is the one. What you do is apply little glue at the bottom of this. Take it and keep it on top of the head. Give a press and you just leave it like this. It will stand over there. Okay, so you should not disturb this. This has to dry completely, and then you have to color the peacock with pearl blue, and then for the beak it is red. pearl blue and pearl green for the body and red for the beak. Now I finished one, the base I have done. Now we'll be clear with all this, the design, everything. Okay, now here this is already painted one. Let me apply the glue and fix the peacock over here. Some more, this has to stand perfectly, right? So let me fix it. Now after this, now the peacock is fixed. I mean the beak and the neck, everything is fixed. So next you take a glitter gold. Also, take glitter gold. Now on this, on the blue, let us do some sort of liner work. So without the liner work, I feel my work is not completed. So let me go with the liner. I always love to do with the liners. Some liner work, anything of your choice. It can be glitter or it can be plain regular liners. So let me go in for pearl metallic liner. Denotes the feathers sort of, and on the blue also I'm little bit of doing some decorations. Then this side, okay, so both the sides you need to do. Then similarly here also, let me complete. So all over the around the peacock I have done the liner work. After this you need to cut at the base. Here I told you the center, exact center, you just give a deep cut. You can even turn the piece also and cut over there little bit extra. Oh my god. And then you take a stapler. You just fold this like this, bring both the ends together like this. I will do it, I'll staple it and then I'll show you. See, at the back, you need to bring these two ends together. I'll just remove this and I'll show you. Bring both the ends like this, the cut together like this, staple it, making a sort of cone shape. So the peacock will stand like this. Okay, now here let me fix the peacock. Let me fix the peacock. Definitely it needs time to dry. I'll show you towards the end. We have one more item. So your table deco will be like this. You can just keep it on the table like this. It will stand. Okay, this is the third item. Hope you all love this, you like this. Definitely I request you all to try one like this. Now we will move on to the last item. It is a clutch with a jute and a decoration on it. Okay, now let it dry. Just keep it there. Now the next item is the clutch. For that you need a rectangular piece. Here I'm going to make it as a checkbook holder, or you can call it as a clutch like that. So it's quite a bigger one. No size for this. So a big one. It is an a rectangular piece. It is not square. So now what you do is you have to mark the center. Just fold it like this. Okay, give a press. See, now I'm doing it on the jute, and see how I'm pressing it with the backside of the scissors. give pressing at both the ends and then continue to the other end like this. Press nicely. Okay, this is the center of the piece, the rectangular piece which we have taken. Now you bring this fold to the center. This is called the cupboard folding. The cupboard has two doors like this. Okay, so we have marked the center here. We have marked the center here. So now we are bringing the one side corner to the center, exactly to the center, and then folding it. One side. Then bring the other end also to the center. Also to the center. Place it first properly. Then give a press in the center like this. And then you move to one corner. This folding and all should be perfect. No cutting. So it's just origami style folding. So we need to do it perfect. Then to the other corner. Okay, so now we are done with the cupboard folding. Now you open it. Then to one corner, make a small fold of 1 inch. A small fold like this. This you try along with me on with a paper. You can take an A3 size paper and do it. Of course the size will be smaller, but you will be familiar with the folding. Make a note, first fold is making it into half, and then the second fold is cupboard folding, and third one we unfold it and then make 1 inch fold on both the sides. Similarly, this side also, press nicely and then make a fold. I'm sure until here you are all clear with the folding for this. Okay. Then see, it's like this. We bring it to the, see, from the center. First it was almost to the center, and then we gave a 1 inch fold like this. Now you press nicely all these folds. Everything should be pressed nicely. Now here what you do is this corner. You have four corners like this, so make a fold like this from here. Sorry, make a fold like this. Once again you press it. This is on one side, then the second side at the top itself. So the pressing should be nice and folding also should be perfect. See, that is why the first box folding I did it on a paper, because it takes time. But this I didn't want to disappoint you, so I'm doing it on the jute itself. So both the sides we have done. Now the other side. Just like the top, the bottom portion. Give a nice press. We are not sticking anywhere. Okay. Then this corner. Now we are done with this kind of folding on at the four corners. Now slowly you turn the jute like this, facing the right portion facing you. Okay, give a nice press and fold. Now you need to divide it into three, equal three. So you need not have to measure it, just fold it like this. Fold it and then you fold it like this. Okay, give a press. Now here you need to give a good press. Now what you do is, the final thing, you take these two ends, just fold it like this, you insert it into this, like this, interlock it, just push it inside like this, one half, that is one third we did like this, and this is the second of the third three portions. And this is the last one. So the last one, you are pushing it inside the first one, interlocking with the first one. Okay. Then after that, once you are ready with this, just you fold it like this. Now we are ready with the pouch, the clutch or the holder, file folder, whatever you call it. Now we are ready with this. This is how it will be. Now you need to give nice folding and then we need to decorate it. For decoration, we are going to do some liquid embroidery style stitches. Suppose if you don't want to do any decoration on top of it, or only I'm going to cover this rexin based portion, that is why I said I'm going to do some kind of decoration. Suppose if you don't want that, you can use this as a pouch over here, folder, another one at the back, two numbers, then you have here and here, four, and then one more here. So you have five secret places to keep your things. Okay. You can concentrate your work over here, but I'm going to cover this portion and leave this portion as it is. So for that, let me go in for a black fabric and do some liquid embroidery stitches on this. I'm going to show you just the techniques and a finished piece, how it looks. Now, any kind of liquid embroidery stitch you can carry out. Let me take some mica mirrors, the liners, of course, different colors, whatever you are with, take golden color, squeeze a little bit. Take a round mirror or a chunky, place it on top, and then using the brush or the pencil, give a press. Now with the same gold, keep dots all around the mirror. Then take some other color liner and radiating lines, you can have like this. A very simple technique I am teaching you. You can try with different kinds of liquid embroidery style stitches using these liners. Okay, this is one kind. Now like this, you need to measure the length of the clutch, the length of this, the full length of this, little on this side, little on that. Accordingly, you have to measure and then do the work on it. Then let me do some lazy daisy stitch. Let's put a tilak shaped. 5 numbers. Then take white color. These are, I'm just showing you the technique, that's it. I'm not going to complete it. At the tip you can do like this, replicating the lazy daisy stitch with a center dot also. Okay, then herringbone stitch also I'll just show you here for the border. Just start from here, very close to one another, following the line drawn, zigzag stitch I'm doing. Okay, like this you have to do different kinds of stitches on the black fabric, because this black fabric will go good on the mustard color, I mean the golden color. So let me show you a finished piece. This is the liquid embroidered piece I have done. You can see the different kinds of stitches I have done. You could see the lazy daisy and then the mirror stuck, then chain stitch I have, then Kanta style of work, once again the chain stitch, and then Zardosi style. So different kinds of stitches I have done on the black fabric. Then take this what we have done, the clutch, keep it like this on it, equally on both the sides. One second, let me just adjust the thing. Yes, now what we do is you just place it on top of this, fold it into half exactly. Now this half, the center will go with the center of the clutch. Keep it like this, put it on top, just place it equally, measure on all, on both the sides. Okay, now we can apply glue, fabric glue, first to one side, first to one side, the center and the down portion. You just place it, make it straight and perfect. Okay, one side you place it, then repeat the same thing on the other side. We don't have time to do this liquid embroidery style. I just showed you few stitches. You can follow that. In case if you want, we can have a separate session for liquid embroidery stitches also. And please mention what are the things you would like to have simpler, easier and quicker. And for further, I'm planning to have regular weekend like this, the Saturday sessions. So those who are interested, please message me. We will have regular classes like this. Of course, you need to try along with me, and there's no point in just seeing and going. So you have to get the materials ready, and I will be sharing the materials what all to be get ready with also in the future. So you get everything ready, do a piece, share it with me. So that is the procedure here after it's going to be. Now I'm done with this. See, so this is the fourth one, that is the clutch. So even this is also like origami style of folding. We took a bigger piece of rectangular piece of jute, and then we did the folding, and finally the liquid embroidery style of work on the black fabric and stuck onto the clutch. So in today's session we saw four pieces. Let me share all the four to you again. First one was a box, jute box, of course without the lid. So let me remove the clips. those who are really interested, please do message me, WhatsApp your number, direct message me. We will have a regular session of work. So this is the first one we did, okay, with the jute fabric. Today's was the jute crafts. The second one is a door hanging, a Ganesh door hanging for the festive season. The third one is a table decor. The third one is a table decor. You can just keep it like this. For the time being, I'm keeping a bottle at the back. Once it is dried completely, it stands on its own. I'll just show you. It's like this. It will definitely stand on its own. Just because of this molded clay, I'm just holding it like this. Okay. So this is the third piece we did. And then the fourth piece, of course, was a clutch. Clutch making with the jute fabric. I taught you the pattern also. I mean the folding on the jute itself. I'm sure you would have done it with the paper along with me. And these things, these kind of decorations is yours. You can either go in for liquid embroidery style of work, or kalamkari fabric is available that you can stick over here, or any other motifs to decorate, and any sort of, any kind of, your creativity can be enhanced on this. So please do try and then share your feedback with me. And next week also we will once again meet, and any queries please do ask me right now. I'll be happy to. Anything else? So which one you like the most, the clutch or the table decor or the box or the hanging? As far as I'm concerned, all the four are good. Each one will suit for any, like for gifting and for our cell phone or this thing. And this is a clutch, of course, all of you can do and make use of it. Those who are interested, please share your WhatsApp number. I will get in touch with you. We will have a regular workshop. Thank you, Rashmi. Wow, that's good. Thank you. So do share it with your friends also. So whatever you have learned, let it be for yourself, an exclusive one. Same thing, you just share it with your friends also. Let them also enjoy creating something different. And another one, another piece. This is the same kind of clutch I have done. But here, one more thing, I just forgot to tell you. Just one second. See, after you finish this, folding the clutch, this center portion is seen, no, that rexing thing is seen. So to avoid that, you can take a quality paper. I always say this is like a fabric. This paper is like a fabric, what we use normally for the making the bags. So that you take and then you insert it like this. Cover the portion. You need not have to stick it at all. Just place it inside so that when you open the clutch, it will have a royal look. See, like this. Okay, now this is the clutch. It takes time to set actually. And when you open it, the inside is like this. Okay, sorry, I forgot to tell you. So this is the clutch. And another one, same kind of, see, this is done long ago. And look at the this thing. It is almost set flat. And here I have painted a oriental fish on a canvas sheet and stuck onto the clutch. And another one is, this is a ready-made jute bag available in the market. So on that I have done a Gujari style of painting once again, and very very old one, with the liners. I have created the pattern on a black fabric and stuck onto the bag. So like this, all of you must be knowing only this kind of bags we normally buy from outside from the shops. But these things you can create on your own at home once you are ready with the materials. Please do try. And then these are some of the things. Okay. And anything else? Any other doubts or any other? Yeah, Usha, thank you. Thank you, Prema ma'am. Vatsala Parsadi, thank you so much for joining. Kripa Babu, yes, yes, good, good. Anju, Pavitra Sundar. Is it Pavitra Sundar, my old student from Mumbai? Hope so. And if so, thank you so much. Most of you have shared your numbers also. Thank you so much. I will get in touch with you. We will have regular sessions like this, online sessions. Yeah, thank you, Pavitra. That's so kind of you. How are you and how are your kids? Anuradha Sharma, thank you. Vairegi ma'am, thank you so much. Mahalakshmi, Vasanti, Malati, Deepika, wow, wow. Thank you, Uma. Sharda Iyer, Rashmi Sharma, a regular viewer of my sessions. So kind of you. Jyoti Sriraman, please do try Jyoti. Hope you all like my this thing, items, jute items. So today for a change, we have done on the jute. One is the clutch. Once again, I just repeat. One is the clutch. And then the other one is a door hanging. And then we have the table deco peacock. This takes little time. Table deco peacock. And then a jute box. A holder. You can just keep some this thing, indoor plants also. With a small size miniature pot. As a room deco. This is very simple, and with these eco-friendly side cotton lace and with the cotton flower, I mean the handmade paper flowers, gives you a beautiful look, excellent look. Okay, all of you would have made the foldings of all the three items, I'm sure, and for the peacock also you would have drawn the outline, got thorough with the proceedings. So please do try, and then I think we will close the session, and any doubt please do ask. No doubts, is it? That means I'm so clear with you all. What is that, Vatsala? Ma'am, I am sticking pots for plants in jute. That's good. Yes, you can. On the pots, you can stick jutes and do some work. See, you can take a bottle. I'm just giving you some ideas. You can take a bottle, which we want to normally throw it off. Take a jute fabric, stick in the middle of the pot, do some paintings on it. Okay. And then the rest of the bottle portions, you can cover it with a jute cord. That also will work out very good. And then or jute cord all over the top and the bottom. The center, you can paint some Madhubani design or Varli or any other folk art patterns on a piece of fabric, and then you can attach it. That also you can do. So for that is for the pot deco. Okay. Can we do it on canvas? No. Today's session was purely on jute. This salon, you can do it on canvas. This peacock table deco, you can do it. All this also, you can do it. Absolutely not an issue. But the jute being the topic for today, I've done it. Okay. Vidya, you are my student, is it? TTC, yes, yes, yes. Yeah, Vidya. Recent TTC, yes, good. That is good. So, a nice platform to get connected with you all. As I always say, I think from tomorrow, the unlocking period, slowly they are yeah, this pendant is a decoupage. I didn't paint it. It is a my YouTube channel is, it is not in English actually. I am from South India. Being a Tamilian, I have done it in few of the sessions were in Tamil, and hereafter I'll try to do it in English also. And see, language doesn't matter. You just see the work, how they do it, and you can understand very easily. Since we are all into this art and craft field, I think the language will not be a barrier for us. Next week's syllabus, it's a suspense, Radha. I'll let you know by next Thursday or Wednesday as usual. And somebody was asking this pendant, this thing. Hi, Sangeeta ma'am. Decoupage style. This episode is, tutorial is in my YouTube. You can just subscribe for the channel and you can get benefited. Thank you, Babita. What is the online classes? What are the online classes going on? All kinds of work. I have already started. Some people have shared their numbers and we are going on with that. So those who are interested, please do. Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Prabha. Thank you so much. Yeah, Rashmi, you can understand. Yes, that is what I told you. Language is not a barrier. You just subscribe and then do. There are many. Yeah, Piali, I will allow you. No problem. We share your number. We will come into the this thing and we can have. Name of my channel is Jayashree Narayanan Creations. My session is always Saturday 3 to 4 in my page. Yeah, once again for Smita Artwork, my channel is Jayashree Narayanan Creation. Yeah, the same thing holds for Vijaya Joshi also. Next class is, once again, we will plan by next week. I'll let you know in the page, the topic. Please, the one thing, a small request to you all, get ready with all your materials and try to do it and try to share it also. That is a humble request from my side. And yeah, Srinivasan Mupili, I will add your number. Geeta Upili, yeah, definitely I will add your number. Thank you, Raj Jain. Thank you so much for the compliment. Feeling really honored. So we will wind up for today's session. Just have a look at this. Naan Thangalin Thambaram. Oh, it's gone. So you are from Thambaram. Very good of you. Can you teach to paint? Paint what? Yeah, Nanita, I will add your number. See, sharing, when the session is going on, you have a this thing over there to share. You can share it with your friends, your group, all those things. And what I meant was, whatever you have learned, please do share it with your friends. Make them do it and then you teach them, then you tell them how to go about it, all those things. Yeah, Jayashree, I will add your number. Malati, good, good. Yes, I will definitely add all your numbers and then we will really rock. We will learn more and more new items. So we have been last week we did some jewelry and then we did a ganjifa, so many items we did. This is the seventh session And today we are with the jute craft. See, you just direct message Angel or creatives. You just message me, direct message me your finished article. Yeah, you can send it via messenger. Janani Narayanan, please share your WhatsApp number, direct message me. I will in turn will get in touch with you. Yes, peacock is very good and I love this. I have done one with the canvas also, but that's very old. I didn't want to share it with you. It's lying somewhere, and this is a brand new lovely peacock. Please do try. If suppose in case when you do it, if it doesn't stand, you can give a make a stick at the back like a stand, and then you can make it. I mean, you can keep it on the table. It's a table deco, so you can keep it on the table. You made ganjifa, super super. Yeah, Anuradha, I'll note it down. And many of you have shared the pictures also, ganjifa cards. And not only ganjifa cards, a few jewelry items also they shared. That was really excellent. They have come out of their own ideas, getting the patterns and then doing it with the paint and with other things. Angel, you just message me your number, I'll share mine. Okay. Thank you, Vijaya Joshi. Yeah, so once again, all of you stay safe, stay at home. We will meet very soon with a different item. And then once the shop is open, please go and buy a lot of the liners. And then the colors, the brushes, molded clay, everything. Get ready with all the materials. And then we will do lot of items. So thank you so much. My YouTube, Asha Gupta, my YouTube channel is Jayashree Narayanan Creation. Thank you, Vatsala. Thank you so much. You also stay safe. So nice platform once again to get connected with you all today. A wonderful session. Yeah, that's right. Janani Narayanan, Jayashree Narayanan. That is right. Okay. So, sorry. It is 4:30 now. And hope you all enjoyed the session. Was informative, useful. Please, please, please do try. Thank you, thank you, Mrs. Srinivasan Upili. Thank you for the wishes. The Guru Purnima Day, thank you so much. So it is nice that you all came in contact with me today through this online session.